Hi, welcome back to Hostbox CA channel and back to the tutorial for operating system. So this is the tutorial definitely helpful for preparing the university exam, college level, competitive exam like GATE, NET, whatever may be there. Today we are going to see the topic called process states in operating system and schedulers. Have idea about schedulers? In the previous session I explained about what is multi-programming and multitasking. Please kindly check the playlist, check the videos for continuation for better understanding. And always support our channel. Let's cover session today. So, whenever process state, any operating system follow these states only. That is called new state, another called ready, and another called run, and last one is a terminate. So here, the process has to be in new state when a program present in the second memory that is initiated for the execution. And also, ready state means what? A process moves from new state to the ready state after it is loaded into the main memory and is ready for execution. And run state means what? A process moves from ready state to the run state after it is assigned the completion of our execution. Terminate means what? After completion of the program, after completion of process or execution, it is called termination. Let's go for another mode where we have a diagram, because this is the one by the way of diagram you can understand and better clarity. Okay, so this is a diagram where let's assume that what is my process. Process means what? Running a program, or else I'm writing the C program and typing the system. So that is not a complete process. When I start to execute the program, for example, I have a program called a.c. Once execute, then only once I start to compile and run the program, that time only the process will complete. Till that, not yet completed. So here what happened? Once a process will be there started, and in ready state, lot of process will be there. Okay, lot of process will be there. Then the processes will move from one to another. From run state, then it go for terminate. It is a normal one. So normally any operating system follows steps, that is new, ready, run, and terminate. Now the question is, lot of processes will be there, how it will handle? And now the run state want to access the IO requests, that means IO devices. So what will happen if the case, what happened means it go and then it needs support of schedulers. So here the scheduler will be there. It will schedule each process to the CPU, which process allows the CPU and which process not like that. So based on schedule the each process CPU, then it will go and execute one by one. That's the thing. So here once the, and moreover you have to remember the two times here, that is called preemption and non-preemption. So now preemption and the non-preemption, that you have to remember here. Both are very important. I say one only here. So here, if it's normally execute from new to ready, ready to run, that is terminate. So if the process want to access the IO request and IO devices, what happen? Then it will move to the state called wait or block state. Wait or block state, then it will go for the ready state, remember. Okay, this is the one. When from run to it go wait, after some time it go to the ready state. That is the way of using the non-preemptive. These are considered under the category of non-preemptive. So non-preemptive, you can say what? If the process are running already, we can't forcibly remove the process. For example, process one running, after completed process one only, we can go and consider the process two. After completed process two, we can consider the process three. Okay, but if you come to preemptive, it's not like the deliberate time count up. So if the process move from run to ready, that is called come under the category of preemptive here. Run to ready means preemptive, where it have time slice. For example, if you 4 seconds, P1 process will run for 4 seconds, then whether it's complete or not, the process move to the, then the process will be, second process take up with the CPU. Again, it will take 4 seconds and it go for the process 3. Remember, today all process run with the seconds or microseconds only in the backside of the computer, remember. Okay, so like that, this is the way non-preemptive will help you here. Then now the question, let's assume that we have a secondary memory here and main memory, ready in main memory, that CPU, and run in the main memory like that. And here wait block also main memory. Let's, if you want to consider this process state diagram, you have to consider two states. One is called wait and block, another called a suspend ready. Here what is this of wait block? Suppose let's assume that we are in the new secondary memory, new state. Let's assume that lot of process will be there and process will from ready to run, and whenever access the IO request, if the main memory is full here, remember, if main memory is full, what will happen? Then it will move to the suspend wait here. Suspend, it will go to suspend. Once it get the, there is space in this main memory, it will resume it back to the wait. Again, it go to the ready. So it will happen easily. So if you want to execute 10 process, there will be 5 process executed and 5 process no place means from wait state it go to the suspend state, that is called suspend, then again back to the block here. This is the way we can understand the process state diagram. Then another state called suspend ready. Here what will happen? Suppose again it come to the secondary memory, again the process will be filled. Sorry, memory is filled. Memory it go to the suspend ready. Again suspend ready to it go to the ready, then it come to the resume. So like that we can understand the process state diagram. Remember here scheduler will be there, the scheduler will take care and schedule each process CPU, and from new to ready where we need support of long term scheduler. Okay, whenever from the process move from process start from secondary to main memory, we need support of long term scheduler. Then from ready to run, we always need support of short term scheduler. Upcoming session we definitely see the explanation properly. And here we see, you know, this wait state and suspend ready, suspend wait, these are happen with the help of middle term scheduler. These are the points you have to remember about the process state. Remember, any operating system having the process model and process model having the state of new, ready, when and terminate. Here we have to highlighting point is there two conditions, either is a non-primitive one or whether it's used with the preemptive means with higher priority. Okay, these all are about the process states. And back to PPT here. So here I given some points, free time can read it because somewhat difficulty also there. If any queries or suggestions, please kindly communicate with the social media. And thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, press bell icon for more updates. Thank you.